Adele.
Buffalo Sabres?
No, the Quebec Nordiques, the Stagnies. On which TV series does Ted Danson star? Tim.
Cheers.
Yes. Similes, metaphors, and alliterations are better known as what? Julie.
Word figures, or figures of speech?
Yes, figures of speech. What is the occupation of the person in the movie industry who takes all the film and puts it together into a movie? Trevor.
Editor.
Yes, the editor. What term is given to a piece of land for raising animals and crops? Tim.
Pasture.
Will we accept that? A pasture?
No.
No, not a pasture. More specific, Julie?
Farm.
A farm. Which geographical term refers to China, Japan, and other parts of East Asia? Trevor.
Middle East.
Not the Middle East, Adele.
The Orient?
Yes, the Orient or the Far East. What is the sum of 7, 8, and 6? Tim.
21.
Pardon? 21 is correct. Name the largest island in the world that is found near... Julie.
Australia.
Found near Canada, Tim?
Baffin Island?
No, Greenland. Mm. In which U.S. city would you find Greenwich Village? Kim.
New York.
New York City. Name the extra playing card used in some card games. Trevor.
Joker.
Yes. That's it for our first quickies. We'll be back to continue with HiQ, and we'll start off with team questions. See you in a sec.
With wrestling superstars, it's like having a match right in your own home. Start with the Iron Sheik all set to go. There's the great Hulk Hogan flexing his muscles. And Big John Studd ready for action with anybody. Fly him in the air and have a great time. And you can flip him around and through the ropes in the Sling 'em, Fling 'em wrestling ring. Get all the action with wrestling superstars and new wrestling ring. Each sold separately. It's a grand toy.
Gem, look, new gem, new rock and curl gem. You see the greatest look and most incredible hair when rock and curl gem is there. Whoa, wow, what a smile, she's the prettiest girl. I love new gem, rock and curl.
She's prettier than ever.
I love what you can do with her hair.
You can curl it up, you can tease it out. Rock and curl gem's got hair to rave about.
Each doll sold separately.
Gem,
welcome back to HiQ. Very close games to George Simpson out in front of St. Hilda by 5 measly points, 40 to 35. Mathematics, our first team questions. You may use your calculators in this round. Isn't that nice? First for 5. Reduce 625 over 50 to its lowest terms. Tim.
25 over...
No, sorry. St. Hilda. Its lowest terms. Gotta push that button, Adele.
25 over 1?
No, 12 and a half. Which means the next three will now be open to both teams. Three consecutive numbers added together total 567. What are they? Batteries work in those things? Quickly, Julie.
184, 185, and 186.
No, sorry. Sir George Simpson? 188, 189, and 190. In 1985, the high school team won 23 out of 26 games played. To the nearest tenth, what percent of its games did the team win? Tim.
88.5%.
Right on. What is the perimeter of an isosceles triangle if the non-congruent side is 5 centimeters long and represents 1/5 of the length of the equal sides? Tim.
55 centimeters.
Yes, you got that quickly. Very well done. Okay, we take a look at language arts now. Still with team questions. First for 5. Which famous short story writer was considered the master of the surprise ending? Tim. Kim.
Edgar Allan Poe.
He's Tim, Kim, Tim. No, not Edgar Allan Poe. Julie.
Bradbury.
No, O. Henry or William Sidney Porter. Next three again become open to both teams. In which famous O. Henry story do a pair of kidnappers end up being foiled by a young boy? Julie.
Kidnap.
No. So George Simpson? The Ransom of Red Chief. Which famous Edgar Allan Poe short story deals with a murderer who tries to convince his listeners he is not insane?
The Telltale Heart.
Good. Which famous Shakespeare play deals with a man who is murdered by a group of men, including his best friend? Tim.
Macbeth.
Not Macbeth. Julie.
Othello.
Julius Caesar. Who am I? Our first clue cruise for the morning. 40 points for the first one, diminishing right through to the answer. 10 points for the final clue. I'm a Canadian athlete of heroic qualities. Trevor.
Alex Bowman.
No, sorry. Tim.
Ben Johnson.
A movie based on my life was released a few years after my death. 30 points, Kim.
Terry Fox.
Terry Fox is the guy we're looking for. Well done. Lots of points for you there. The next two clues, if we needed them. I actually gave my life fighting for a cause. My experience that gained national recognition was called the Marathon of Hope. Terry Fox. One more. Who am I? 40 points for the first. I was born a princess. Julie.
Princess Margaret.
Not Princess Margaret, Sir George Simpson. Kim.
Princess Elizabeth II.
No. I was made famous in a children's fairy tale, and my reputation expanded in music by Tchaikovsky. Julie.
Sleeping Beauty?
Yes, Sleeping Beauty. They got 30 the last time, you got 30 this time. The next clue is, if we needed them, my love was Prince Philip, who risked his life to rescue me. My name was Aurora, and thanks to the three good fairies, my life was saved by the wicked old queen, Sleeping Beauty. On to science. What do we call the negatively charged part of an atom? Tim.
Electrons.
Yes, we do. In fact, all the questions now deal with atoms. The next three will now go to Sir George Simpson, and you may confer on these. Atom is a Greek word. What is the meaning of the word? Tim.
The building block of all matter?
No, indivisible. One or more types of atoms are combined to form what? Tim.
Molecules.
What must happen to an atom in order to create an atom bomb? Tim.
It has to go through nuclear fission.
We accept that, yes, or simply
split. Okay, let's split to the music now. We're going to play you some songs. First, identify the name of the artist, then the song, not in reverse order and not two at once, okay? Because we'll only take the first answer.
Song number one. Julie.
Lionel Richie.
Yes, and the name of the song. Julie.
Ballerina Girl.
Good. And finally, number two. Julie.
Christa Berg.
Not Christa Berg. The name of the artist? Sir George Simpson? If we're lucky, they'll sing. Then again, maybe they won't. They are the Jets. And the name of the song? Trevor.
You got it all.
You got it all, and you certainly did. Well done, Trevor. Our third song goes back a couple years. Name of the artist? Julie.
Billy Joel.
Billy Joel. And the name of the song? Adele.
Uptown Girl.
Uptown Girl. Good. Okay. Move on to geography, and the first for five. Which Asian country is Kashmir most closely associated? Julie.
India.
India is correct. The next three will now go to St. Hilda. You can chat on the side if you like about these. Tokyo and Osaka are located on Japan's largest island. Name the island. Julie.
Ashtak?
No, Honshu. Which sea is enclosed by Borneo, the Philippines, and the Asian Peninsula? Julie.
Yellow Sea?
No, the South China Sea. Name any two of three countries that make up the heroin triangle. Any two will do. Julie.
Vietnam and China.
No, Burma, Thailand, and Laos. Those are the three we're looking for. And right now, we're going to be looking at that little TV screen in front of you, and you identified those slides. Number one. Trevor.
Norway.
Not Norway, St. Hilda. Julie.
Finland.
Yes, the flag of Finland. Sort of looks like our Judge Joe Roberts. No, I don't think that's him. No idea? Julian Koziak. Number three. Adele.
Martina Navratilova.
Yes, great tennis player, Martina Navratilova. Which brings us to sports, which only makes sense. Team question, first for five. They used to play their home games in the Checkerdome, but now their hockey is just played in the arena. Name this popular NHL team. Trevor.
St. Louis Blues.
Yes, I guess popular to those people who live in St. Louis. I don't know about anybody else. The next three will now go to you guys, and you may confer on these. First for 10. The Detroit Hockey Arena is named after a great sports figure, Joe Louis. In which sport did Joe Louis excel? Trevor.
Boxing.
Boxing. Name the team for which scoring star Denny Savard plays.
Chicago Blackhawks.
Yes. When he signed, he was considered the franchise of the NHL Winnipeg Jets. Who is he?
Benny Trevor. Smith.
No, Dale Hawerchuk. The score of the Winnipeg Jets. Just want to point out right now, if the audience can please keep it down, I'm hearing answers. Fortunately, you're not hearing them, but those whispers are pretty loud with the acoustics in here. Okay, we're on to news, first for five. Who is the United States Defense Secretary often in the news? Julie.
George Shultz.
No. Sir George Simpson. Trevor?
Weinberger.
Yes, Caspar Weinberger. Next three again to Sir George Simpson. October saw the Soviet government naming a mountain in the northern Caucasus, after which a little girl whose world peace appeal won attention in 1982 and 1983. No guesses? No, this just goes to Sir George Simpson. Samantha Smith. Cardinal Joseph Glimp, a recent visitor to Edmonton, is the head of the powerful Roman Catholic Church in which European country? Trevor.
Italy?
No, Poland. This CBS newsman was chased and beaten as he walked along Park Avenue in New York. Trevor.
Down or other?
You got that. Well done. Our next category deals with our very own country. The subject is Canadiana for 5 points. In which Canadian city was the idea of the telephone conceived by Alexander Graham Bell? Julie.
Halifax?
Not Halifax. Tim.
Montreal?
No, Brantford, Ontario, home of Wayne Gretzky. Something else famous happened there. Who lives in Stornoway in Ottawa? This is open to both teams now. Who lives in Stornoway in Ottawa? Julie.
John Turner.
Not yet. Yes, actually. The leader of the opposition happens to be John Turner. Good. Which Roman Catholic order sent missionaries to Huronia in the 1630s? Jesuits. In New France, what were the coureurs de bois? Julie.
Voyagers?
Do you accept that?
No, we can't accept
that. No, we have to be more specific. So George Simpson, Trevor.
Runners of the woods.
Pardon?
Runners of the woods.
That's what they're called, isn't it? Okay. Independent fur traders, but the actual definition, interpretation is runners of the woods. Which country? Clues, 40 points. I am a federal republic found in Central Europe. Tim.
Soviet Union?
Not the Soviet Union. Sir George Simpson. I am home of much of the world's most beautiful classical music. Julie.
Germany?
No, 30 points, Sir George Simpson. The shilling is one form of currency. German is my official language. 20 points, Tim.
Austria.
Austria is correct. Well done. Finally, in 1938, Hitler made me a part of Germany, Austria. Entertainment. This could be our final team question, first for five. Whose voice was always heard as Charlie on the TV series Charlie's Angels? Kim.
John Forsythe.
Good. The next three to Sir George Simpson for 10 points. Who was Captain Kangaroo's assistant on the popular program for children? Didn't watch Captain Kangaroo? Mr. Green Jeans. In 1984, he had the best-selling solo album ever. Who was he? In fact, he still is that guy. Trevor.
Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson. With whom did Mr. Jackson sing the 1984 number one hit, Say, Say, Say? Trevor.
Paul McCartney.
And can you sing it for me?
No.
No? No points involved anyway. That's fine. It's commercial time. We'll see you in a moment with more High Q.
Good always triumphs over evil when a Care Bear smiles your way. Join Love A Lot, Cheer Bear, and all the other Care Bears every Saturday at 3, right here on ITV.
A new fruit drink from Kool-Aid with 25% juices.
Chicken, I sit, shake it, pop it, Kool-Aid. Sip it, hip it, pop it, Kool-Aid. I see food is super juicy. Kool-Aid coolers make it cooler. Pack it, pocket, play it cooler. Sack it, sock it, see it cooler. I see food is super juicy.
With no preservatives.
Kool-Aid coolers make it cooler.
You can't hold nothing.
Yes, we can.
You can't see nothing.
Yes, we can.
You can't eat nothing.
Oh, yes, we can.
Inside Aero are millions of bubbly nothings, which can only be seen when they're covered by Roundtree's delicious milk chocolate. Bubbly nothings that do nothing except taste good, which is amazing for a nothing to do.
Hey, what are you eating?
Nothing, nothing.
Hey, what are you eating?
Nothing.
nothing like it.
Bee leader to all bees, the big taste of honeycomb is directly below. Dive, dive.
It's giant honeybees. They're trying to put a big bite on our honeycomb.
Don't worry, kids, I've got a big bee swatter. Whoa!
Oh. Honeycomb Kid, you saved the day.
I did, right. Oh, shucks, nothing to it.
Post Honeycomb, one big honey of a cereal.
Start your day with high energy. It's Body Moves at 6 and a great workout. Then at 7, Charlene Prickett and her gang bring you It Figures. They concentrate on floor exercises to tighten those stomach muscles. ITV for the health of it. Weekdays at 6 a.m.
Welcome back. So George Simpson out in front of St. Hilda, 225 to 135. We now move on to another What Am I group of clues for 40 points. I am a former popular television series. Julie.
Brady Bunch.
Not the Brady Bunch. Sir George Simpson. Trevor.
Happy Days.
The original concept for my comedy program came from England. Kim.
Three's Company.
No, although it did, that's true. St. Hilda, good guess. I was the number one show from October of 1971 to April of 1976. Finally, with me, the term male chauvinist really came to be along with bigot as it applied to my star, Carol O'Connor. Julie.
All in the Family?
All in the Family is correct. Well done. Okay, one more What Am I group of clues before we get into spelling. I'm a type of spice which Sri Lanka is the largest producer. Julie.
Cinnamon?
Cinnamon is correct. 40 points. Boy, you're getting closer on that one. The next three clues, if we needed them. I come from a tropical evergreen tree and is aromatic bark. I am used often in bakeries on the top of certain products. Rolls and buns and toast can be covered by me to add a different flavor to these items. Cinnamon. That really closed the gap significantly there. Okay, spelling. We can do it even more here. 10 points if you spell the word correctly. 5 if you use it in a sentence without repeating the definition that I have read you. We'll start off with Sir George Simpson. Trevor, your word is disciplinary, relating to use in discipline, punishment given to train or correct. Disciplinary.
D-I-S-C-I-P-L-I-N-A-R-Y.
That's right, good.
His disciplinary teacher was very strict.
That good? Okay, Tim. Changeable, likely to change, variable, changeable.
C-H-A-N-G-E-A-B-L-E.
Mm-hmm.
His changeable manner, confused the teacher.
Kim, chauffeur, a person whose work is driving an automobile for somebody else. Chauffeur.
C-H-A-U-F-F-E-R.
F-F-E-U-R, sorry, Kim. St. Hilda, Adele, anxious, uneasy, worried, fearful about what might happen. Anxious.
A-N-X-I-O-U-S.
Good.
Her anxious behavior was very nerve-wracking.
Okay, Julie. Apologetic, expressing regret, making an apology to seek forgiveness. Apologetic.
A-P-O-L-O-G-E-T-I-C.
That's right.
Her apologetic reply made him reconsider.
Good. Tim, eligible, qualified or meeting requirements for something. Eligible, Tim.
E-L-I-D-G-A-B-L-E.
Would have been right except for that D. Sorry about that. Moving along to mathematics, remember from here on in, all the questions will be open to both teams and worth 10 points. Reduce the fraction 83 over 6 to lowest terms. Tim.
15 and a half?
No. St. Hilda?
13 and 4/5?
No, 13 and 5/6. Mm-hmm. So close, and yet so far. 7.35 kilograms equals how many grams? Julie.
7,350.
Good. What is the value of -7 squared? Tim.
49.
Yes. How much change is left if you buy a $53.59 camera using a $100 bill? Tim.
$46.41.
That's the answer we're looking for as we move along to jock talk, or sports. For 10 points, which former Edmonton Oiler is known as the Rat? Trevor.
Ken Linsman.
Yes, now plays for the Boston Bruins. Who won an olive wreath as a prize? Julie.
Wayne Gretzky.
No, this not Wayne Gretzky. It's a George Simpson. This goes back a number of years. The winner of ancient Greek Olympics. What is the basic difference between the Canadian and American football fields? Trevor.
30 yards.
Well, we'll accept that. I was longer would have done it, but yeah, we'll accept that. Good. In 1976, she became the first gymnast to receive a perfect Olympic score. Kim.
Nadia Comaneci.
Good. Well done. On to current events. 10 points for this question. Who is the Attorney General of Canada? Adele.
Jean Sauvé.
Not Jean Sauvé. It's George Simpson. Ray Natijan. The Labor Relations Board ruled that this company violated Alberta's labor laws by firing 28 employees after learning they were trying to join a union. Name the company. Julie.
Mariposa.
Good. This aging baseball team was eliminated in the 1986 American League playoffs. Trevor.
California Angels.
That's right. Which Alberta political leader owns the near bankrupt oil company known as Tim.
Taylor.
Yes, Nick Taylor, Lochiel Exploration Limited. Good. On to language arts for 10 points. A very deformed individual, he loved the beautiful Esmeralda. Julie.
The Hunchback of Notre Dame. Quasimodo.
We accept that? She said Quasimodo too. You got him. Good. Name the Roman goddess born from the brain of Jupiter. Tim.
Oh.
Julie.
Hera.
No, Athena. Which punctuation mark is used to indicate a slight pause? Trevor.
Comma.
Which punctuation mark is used to indicate time using numbers? Tim.
Colon.
Dot, dot, sure. Geography. What is the other name by which the Canadian section of Niagara Falls goes by? Tim.
The Horseshoe Falls?
Yes, Horseshoe Falls. Which highway was built by the U.S. Army in 1942 and 1943? It's the Alaska Highway. What is the scenic drive along the Cape Breton coast called? Called Cabot Trail. Royal Roads Military College is found in which province? Julie.
Ontario.
Not Ontario. It's where the Royal Military College is. So George Simpson? Pick a province. Trevor.
Alberta.
No, British Columbia. Close by though. Moving along to science for 10 points. In which part of the body is there a swelling that is a sign of goiter? Julie.
Throat.
We accept that? Yes, the throat or neck. What is botulism an acute form of? Kim.
Food poisoning.
What major function other than hearing is provided by the ear? Julie.
Balance.
Good. What do we call the prime reusable vehicle of the U.S. space transportation system? Julie.
The moon buggy.
No. It's George Simpson. Trevor.
Space shuttle.
That's the one, the space shuttle. Canadiana. Final group of questions before the quickies. Who was the first explorer to cross Canada by land? Julie.
Hudson.
Not Hudson. It's George Simpson. Trevor.
Roger.
Alexander Mackenzie. Which explorer found a social club called the Order of Good Cheer? Julie.
Champlain.
Good. Which Nova Scotian founded one of the great steamship companies of the world? Julie.
Quebec.
Not Quebec. So George Simpson. Samuel Cunard. Born in Montreal, she is among the foremost contralto vocalists in the world. Julie.
Maureen Forster.
That's right. You got that. Well done. Okay, we now move along to quickies. I thought I moved along to quickies. I must. Okay, now we move along to quickies. What nationality was author Hans Christian Andersen? Julie.
Dutch.
Not Dutch. So George Simpson. Tim.
Denmark.
Yes, he was Danish. Which former FBI head was responsible for an attack on the mafia? It was J. Edgar Hoover. Who is said to be the father of psychiatry? Julie?
Sigmund Freud.
Who was the king of rock and roll? Kim?
Elvis Presley.
The Marie Celeste is a famous ship abandoned where? In the Bermuda Triangle. Which famous French prison was stormed during the French Revolution? Julie?
Bastille.
Good. What are you doing if you are working in a tempora? Working in tempora. What are you doing? Julie?
Cooking.
No. It's George Simpson. not tempura. Painting. Who painted the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel? Julie.
Michelangelo.
You are practicing on the carillon. What instrument are you playing? Tim.
Steam organ.
So George Simpson. Kim.
Guitar.
Bells. Whose biggest hit song was Tie a Yellow Ribbon? Tim.
Tony Orlando.
Yes, Tony Orlando and Don. If a racehorse finishes in the show position, where did he finish? Tim.
Third.
Who was Andy Capp's wife? Tim.
Flo.
Yes, good. What is the score of a forfeited baseball game? Trevor.
9-0.
What do we call it when a nuclear reactor overheats and the core melts? Kim.
Meltdown.
What position did Henry Kissinger and Alexander Haig both hold in government? Julie.
Vice President.
No. Trevor.
Secretary of State.
What is the scientific study of plants called? Julie.
Vegetation. No,
so George Simpson. Tim.
Botany.
Who is considered the father of modern classical music? Tim.
Beethoven.
Not Beethoven. So George Simpson. Johann Bach. What is explained by a legend on a map? Julie.
Distance.
Will we accept that? No? So George Simpson? Do we have an answer? The map's symbols. That bell signifies the end of high Q. We'll have a winner in just a moment, so don't go too far away.
Each oodle comes with its own collectible little card. Oodles may be purchased separately or in families of 6 or 12. It's a grand toy.
Even my poodle's got an oodle.
And more Autobots join Optimus Prime. Cup.
Reminds me of the battle on Beta 4.
Hot Rod.
Watch my smoke.
Blur.
Now you see me. Now you don't.
And these are the new Decepticons, the evil Cyclonus.
I'm sparring for a fight.
And Scourge.
No one escapes the sweeps.
But soon, a new Autobot leader will arrive. Introducing Rodimus Prime. No one can take on the Decepticons like Rodimus Prime.
Transformers.
Robots in disguise.
The Transformers, each sold separately from Hasbro.
In another well-fought battle of the brains, Sir George Simpson has defeated St. Hilda 425-335. Thank you to St. Hilda for a very good game. And Adele Aiken, Julie Lee, Timothy Rasol. And it's Sir George Simpson. You now continue on in the third round of the championship series. Congratulations to Trevor Lovig, Tim Heyer, and Kim Spicer. As well, a great job performed by Joe Roberts, our judge. And thank you very much for watching High Q. We'll be back next week with another great game. See you then.
Disgusting. But hey, everybody, don't let that stop you from watching. Some of us still know how to control our tongues.
Right. By the way, Egbert, did you hear that?
No, you're kidding. Tell me more.